Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, today's video starts right in front of this beautiful e-corner. The reason being, we're going to talk about the topic of how I got from Christian Orthodoxy to the New Age and back again to Christian Orthodoxy. So, in order to understand this process, we have to go way, way back to the beginning. Here you can see, yes, this is little me with a little bit less beard and a little bit more hair. And here you can see my parents and little me in the middle. This is my beautiful sister. So that said, how did it all start with this family being Christian Orthodox by default and me being baptized? But this is as religious as it gets. Yes, I was baptized. Yes, my parents were Christian Orthodox. However, we went to church on Easter and on Christmas twice per year tops. Nobody knew anything about the Bible. We heard about Jesus. Nobody really prayed before dinner or something. We had no real connection. We didn't know what the Orthodox celebrations were about, who the church fathers are, who the saints are, nothing about it. We were just Christian Orthodox by default. However, that being said, every single night I would pray. This was pretty innocent. As a little kid, I would lay in bed and pray to God for my family, for my friends, for my little wishes to come true, so on and so forth. It wasn't really religious, but I always felt a connection to God. However, at some point, this connection got cut. And today I want to talk about how that happened. It happened with a Google search on the internet, on which I found a term that I never heard before, called lucid dreaming. I was intrigued right away. I started Googling, I started researching. I couldn't get enough about that concept because what it was promising was mind-blowing. On the internet, I could read that you can do anything you want. You can manipulate your dreams. You can have sex with celebrities. Ooh. And you can have all the riches in the world. All your desires can be satisfied in your lucid dreams. But even more than that, you can leave your body. You can have an outer body experience. You can have an astral projection. Wow, how mystical that sounds. How amazing is that? You can leave your body, explore your surroundings, and even dive into parallel dimensions, parallel universes even. I had to try it out, but it came with a catch. Because before you would go to sleep, you would have to meditate. You would have to meditate, you would have to concentrate, you would have to go through certain muscle relaxing exercises. To cut the story short, you would get away from your nightly prayer. This is what happened to me. I wasn't praying anymore at night. I was focusing on my lucid dreams. On top of that, I don't know if you guys know about lucid dreams, but in order to become proficient at it, even in your daily life, you have to do things called reality checks. There is this fascinating thing about dreams that everything can seem crystal clear, but one thing cannot. So how would you know that you're not dreaming right now? It could be a dream, right? You're watching a Bobby's Perspective YouTube video and then you wake up. How could you test that it is a dream? So the explanation for that is that hands never look like hands in the dream world. Everything else can be ultra crisp, full HD. Your hand will have six fingers or seven. It will look blurry. And therefore, in your daily life, you have to double check and always check your hand. Do you still have five fingers or not? And then automatically at some point you will start doing that in your dreams and you will realize that you are dreaming. All right, enough of lucid dream tutorials. I got deep involved into it and I did it for 3 years straight. kind of sounds similar to my vegan story. Yes, I went vegan for 4 years. I did lucid dreaming for 3 years. When I do something, I do it right. I do it 100% in order to understand what it is. I don't feel competent talking about subjects that I haven't experienced to 100%. So, again, long story short, cutting off my rant, what happened is I stopped praying. Simple as that. I stopped praying and I was only worried about lucid dreaming. And lucid dreaming, even though it is seen as a spiritual practice, honestly, like all the other spiritual practices, you are involved with feeding your ego. You're just feeding your ego. I want to fly. I want to do this in my dream, that in my dream. It is all about I. What can I experience? How can I further pleasure myself, satisfy myself? I don't have a fast sports car in real life. I want to drive it in my dream, right? I want to have sex with that woman. Absolutely pathetic. But as a 20-year-old, it was alluring. So that being said, this was my first introduction to the New Age without realizing it. I didn't think twice. All I had in mind was exploring the dream world. From there out on, I got into meditation, because meditation can further enhance the lucid dreaming experience. Then I heard about sleeping herbs, certain substances, certain herbs that can make you dream more vividly, even certain amino acids, so on and so forth. I got intrigued by that as well, needless to say. And the next thing that followed is that I started experimenting with drugs. How will it work with weed? How will it work with MDMA? How will it work with speed? So on and so forth. And all of a sudden, I found myself in the party scene, in the drug scene, consuming, selling myself, going further and further into it. All, of course, under this premise of spirituality. All of it, of course, under the premise of certain spiritual development, of evolving further into a light being and whatnot. What I'm saying is, guys, it was a slippery slope that I didn't see coming. Needless to say, this lifestyle wasn't sustainable and I got really, really sick. I talked about that in my mushroom video, I'm gonna link it here. I got really, really sick, got an autoimmune disorder, was completely knocked out and couldn't continue with my degenerate lifestyle, thank God. I couldn't continue with the partying, I couldn't continue with the fornication, I couldn't continue with the drugs, etc. And with that, I had to lay low for quite a long time. I was battling this autoimmune disorder until my good friend gave me some magic mushrooms. And I'm not gonna dive too deep into this topic, otherwise it's gonna take me 2 hours. I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. However, the magic mushrooms healed my autoimmune disorder. Amazing, right? Amazing. The physical aspect of it was nothing short of breathtaking. I was healed. My autoimmune disorder was gone after 1.5 years of suffering. However, magic mushrooms come with a little side effect. They come with a spiritual experience. And to this very day, I can't say that mushrooms are negative or positive. They're neutral at best. However, they open up a door. And once that door is opened, anybody can come in. Good and bad. And very, very bad. So, everything is under the disguise of, yet again, spirituality, some sort of epic experience, light beings. But, as we do know now in Christian Orthodoxy, even Satan can disguise himself as an angel of light. Something that I didn't know back then. You see it with many people. Many people, especially now in those days, are fed up with the system. They can't see it anymore. It sucks, I understand. And what do they say then? I want to experience something else. Once they experience mushrooms, ayahuasca, they see another reality. But they mistake that reality for ultimate truth. Everything else is false, that must be true. But even in that spiritual realm, you have deceptive entities. You have malicious beings. Not everybody has your best interest in heart. The reason why I say this is that even though the mushrooms healed my physical body, they further brought me into the new age. I got interested more and more in Buddhism, Hinduism, yoga, tantra, and whatnot. Shamanism especially was very interesting. I ended up in the Amazon jungle, right, where I drank ayahuasca with the shamans, so on and so forth. Long story short, yet again, everything that had to do with Christ was bad, and everything else super interesting, right? Anything else, you can tell me about anything but Christianity. And that is a phenomenon that deserves a video on its own. It is amazing to see that many people in our Western civilization don't want to hear about God. They don't want to hear about Christianity, right? It's a taboo.
Oh, Bobby, can't you please stop talking about God? Otherwise, I'm gone.
Please, please leave. I don't need you here. Right now, I'm doing YouTube for recreation. I upload once in a while, when I feel like it. I don't need people that don't want to hear my message. It's called Bobby's Perspective. If you like it, stay here, watch it, leave a thumbs up. Thank you very much. If not, bye-bye. All good, no stress. However, isn't it interesting to see that in this Western world, you will accept anything, right? Check this out. This is the bookshelf of my sister. What can we find here from back in the day? A yoga book, the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, lucid dreaming, Falun Dafa, feeling good, all kinds of new age books. And I was reading some of them myself. Even pickup books. Wow. Some of them are mine. Absolutely amazing. Everything is interesting. Everything is fascinating. But Christianity. Christianity is bad. Christianity sucks, right? Even Islam is welcomed. Otherwise, we are Islamophobes. But please not Christianity. Don't tell me about Jesus. You are a Bible thumper. Disgusting. Why is that so? Who hates Jesus? Who hates God? The devil. Simple as that. And it is the devil that is in the new age. All of those books should be burned. I'm telling my sister that, and I hope we can get to it, to burn them and make a big barbecue over them, hopefully. Anyways, from lucid dreaming into drug experiences, further into the new age shamanism, so on and so forth, further and further away from Jesus, until I finally opened up my heart and let Jesus in. I know, you don't want to hear it. I get it. We hate God. I get it. We all do. We are wicked at heart and we don't want to hear about it. Just ask yourself the question, isn't it fascinating that if I would talk about yoga today, about NoFap, about cold showers, you would listen. If I would talk about carnivore, you would listen. But if it comes down to Christ, nope, we're shutting down. We can't listen to it. Ask yourself why that is. Of course, I believe that I do know why that is, because I do see demonic possession everywhere. I really do. I do see that the devil is in the detail and that we are truly wicked at heart and that we don't want to obey. I see that clearly now. I didn't. We want to rebel. The first rebel in creation was Lucifer. And we are following his example. We're following the example of the devil. We do not want to bow down to God's will. We want to rebel and further do our own thing because it feels so good. Because well-being, right? Well-being is the most important thing nowadays. This is where the doctrine of devils originated from, right? This is how veganism came about. We take the premise that well-being is the best. Well-being is so good. We all have to feel good. Right? And this is why we don't eat the animals. It is a slippery slope. This is how I got into veganism. From the New Age, from the Buddhism, the Hinduism, into vegetarianism, into veganism. It is all connected. And I know I sound like a madman ranting, but it was something that I had to connect the dots to after I went through it. It was a slow, slippery slope, as I said. Without realizing it, starting with the lucid dreams, ending up as a vegan fruitarian with 60 kilograms body weight, absolutely drained of my life force. Why? Why was I drained of my life force? Of course, it is easy to see it superficially, to look at it and say,
yeah, you were so thin because you didn't eat enough.
Yes, duh, Einstein. But why didn't I eat enough? Why didn't I nourish my body? How did I get into it? How did I get into fasting practices? Why did I believe that fasting on fruits, on juices, is a good idea? Nobody thinks deeper.
He's such an idiot, and this is why he drank juice for 30 days.
Think about it, man. There must be a motivator behind it. Behind everything in your life, there is a motivator. Why do you get up and go to work? Is it for money? Is it because you love it? What is the motivator? What is the motivator behind somebody getting out and shooting up heroin? There's always a motivator behind good and bad. And I do say that there is a spiritual motivator behind it as well. That there are demonic powers at hand that lead us and that we are giving into because we hate God. We close our heart up to that truth. Everybody, if they're asking their own conscience, everybody will agree that the Ten Commandments are true. We say that the Ten Commandments are written in your heart. It is true. You can't deny it. You shall not kill. You shall not lie. You know it. You know that this is true, but still you're ignoring it. You're getting away with little lies, with stealing little things. You're getting away with it, right? With lusting after women, after men. We're getting away with it. We don't want to grow up. We don't want to listen to the ultimate authority, the Alpha and the Omega. We can't do it because we want to be in charge. Because pop culture feeds us that belief. That we are all little celebrities. Here, hey, look at me. Woohoo. Yeah, social media. Bobby's Perspective. Click subscribe. Woohoo. Awesome, right? We're all little celebrities. Look at me. Look at me. Ain't I pretty? Absolutely ridiculous, right? False gratification. This is why I went off social media for a while. To reflect and to see what is true. This is why I went to Athos. On that note, I have to still do a video. Sorry for the delay, guys. But I have enough in my daily life to do. Yes, even under quarantine, there's a lot to do aside from social media. Anyways, I must be the worst channel salesman. This is definitely not how you run a successful YouTube channel. But that's besides the point, because I really do not care. I do not care about the clicks. On that note, I heard that many, many times.
Bobby just cares about the clicks, and this is why he does anti-vegan videos.
No, I do anti-vegan videos because veganism is the doctrine of devils. If you dive into the spiritual aspect, you always have a battle between good and evil, between carnivore and veganism. Simple as that. This is why I talked so passionately about it, because it wrecked my health, my family's health, and this is why I wanted to warn people. And now, again, passionately, I'm talking about what brought me away from God, what brought me into the New Age. Take it or leave it. I hope it helps you guys. It is little things. It can be The Power of Now that you just read, a little book. Could be a YouTube video, right? Could be a yoga seminar. It is those little things that further and further bring you into the New Age and away from God. All right, guys, but this is it for today's video. I think it's long enough. It is a little bit unorganized all over the place, but I hope you enjoyed this rant, this slightly different format. If so, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, guys, please do so. And as always, guys, may God bless you and much love and peace.